Scrap. Good.
Hey, Dig. I'm starting to get worried.
Yeah, I guess I've been gone a while.
Remember hitting the road on days like this. Nothing better than the sun on your back.
Hey, we'll get out there again. I never did finish burning out this nesting zone. Another one. Yeah, time to light it up. Gotta be close to a nest. Whew, I can smell it. There's another nest. Let's burn it up. Guess I'll come back later, burn out these nests. There we go. Nest. Let's go.
More bounties.
Should be clear now. Damn freaker nest. Should be safer to move through here now. Fix this. That'll hold.
Hey.
Okay, here we go. Okay. Come on, come on. Shit, almost out. Thank you.
years is it gonna take before all of this is finally gone? Nice refugee camp. Yeah, you're all a little better off out in the shit. Nero couldn't protect you from a goddamn thing.
Headshot.
It's not here. You got that? Feed wherever the hell you want, but not here. This camp is mine. It's not yours. You got that? Yeah, that's right. No more for you. Get the hell out of my camp. How many of you sons of bitches are there? Huh? Any of you left? How many?
Another micro recorder. One of these is gonna explain what the hell
emergency.
You guys are doing.
This is refugee right camp 13 Delta. My survivor
Jack. We're on the run! Tell them!
Shut up, I'm trying!
They gotta pick us up!
Shut up! Shut up, I'm trying to. Repeat, this is refugee camp 13 Delta. We're being overrun. Do you read me?
Give me that!
What are you doing?
Let's go! Give me
let's go!
Radio! You.
Hey, babe. Yeah, I cleaned them out. They won't be bothering you no more. Hey, me again.
Deacon, I'm gonna tell you something.
Hey, it's okay, it's just my arm.
You told me that we shouldn't come back, and I didn't listen to you, and then I knew that it was getting worse, but I...
None of us knew it was gonna go away like this. It's fast.
You don't understand. I don't know what I would do if I lost you. This is my fault.
Hey, I won't lose an aim. I made a promise. Remember?
Deacon, wait!
Sarah, come on.
There's a kid here.
Wait.
Hey. Hey, are you okay? Come on, we gotta find your parents, okay?
Hey,
come on. Oh, stabbed me. I don't know. I don't think it's that bad.
Okay. Just hold this here as soon as you can. Run.
I don't think so. I think I can walk.
You're good enough. Almost there.
Okay.
2 hours ago, this place was calling the feds.
Yeah, they must have evacuated.
Yeah, they must have bugged the hell out.
Yeah, she's burning up. The knife must have nicked her kidney or something. She's turning septic. How you doing, little sister?
So stupid. It was this little kid. This goddamn little kid.
Big goddamn knife.
Hey, help me.
Shit.
Hey, Mom. You want to be when we come through?
We gotta get to the roof. Flag down one of those choppers.
Right. Yeah, see if you can rest over here.
Hey. Easy.
She reminded me so much of my little sister, you know. She used to play that hide and seek game all the time. She would just hide her head in her coat just like that.
I've been cutting my name, but nothing like that.
She's burning up.
Jesus. Look at her.
We gotta move.
We ain't going that way.
Come on. Hey, sweetheart, can you move? Closer.
Yeah, I got her. Go find this way out.
It's nothing. Go.
I got this. Go.
Hold on. Don't.
Fuck you.
Yeah, we see you got guns, guys. Stop shooting.
Sir? Hey. I'm unarmed.
Get out.
Now listen to me. My girl's out there. She's been stabbed. We're just trying to get to the roof.
Get out.
There's
here.
A helicopter.
You killed her.
So listen.
You killed my wife.
Look, I didn't know anything about your wife being killed. I am sorry, sir. Do anything. What are you doing? Give me your gun!
My wife! Stop them!
Wait, we need help. She's been wounded.
What's wrong with her?
Well, she's not. Whatever the hell's going on out there, she's been stabbed.
I can't take anymore.
Oh, okay. Listen, O'Brien. If we don't get her to a hospital, she's going to die.
There are no more hospitals.
Oh, come on. No more hospitals. You got doctors, you got triage, you got a mass unit.
Oh, look, I'm just a grad student, okay? I got volunteered for this. I'm not even supposed to be out here, okay?
O'Brien.
Okay. I've only got room for two of you, okay? Two.
You got room for two of
you? You're overweight, okay? I can only take two of you. Two.
Come on, help me. Come on. All right, sweetheart. That's okay. You're gonna be all right.
I got her.
Boozer, let's go. We gotta get on that guy. We gotta get on that chopper.
I heard what he said. There's only room for two on that chopper. Go. Go with her. I'll be okay. Look, I've been through worse shit than this before. You know?
Here we go. Where are you going?
What?
Where?
Refugee camp, west of Three Finger Jack.
No.
Boozer is never gonna make it without me. I want this back.
You coming?
You rest easy, okay? I'll be back to check on you. And I know, yeah, you wouldn't want me to, but I guess Boozer's right. I can't help myself. It's like I said, I'll be back. Boozer? Another Nero chopper. Wonder what the hell they're up to. fuel can.
This is Radio Free Oregon. The truth shall set you free. Today, I was thinking about where it all began. The roots go deep. Back to the big WW2. In 1947, the feds passed what they call it, the National Security Act. Now, what this did was give the feds the right to take over our roads, railroads, and radio. Anything they damn well pleased. Without a warrant. Today, feds are gone, but we're still here, shining the spotlight of truth on the world. Truth is, I seen it coming. Years ago, we had photos. Hero death camps built to hold us, American citizens. No one believed me. If more of us had spoken up, none of this would have happened. Tell you one thing, it won't happen again. This is Mark Copeland for Radio Free Oregon. Don't believe the lies.
Well, you were right about one thing, Cope. All these Nero refugee camps, they did turn out to be death camps, just not the way you were expecting.
Freaks, boozer, you got that? Bounties. That's the only reason that I go up there.
Hold on, they're slowing down. Looks like they're stopping.
Oh,
just, warning shots. I mean, if they were trying to hit me, I would be dead.
Deke, remember me telling you about that death wish of yours?
Yeah, I got this. Deacon out.
Okay, is the radio all right?
God damn it, get back here with that! Shit, that's mine! Ah, finally. Jesus Christ, those shits can run fast.
So, what the hell are they doing?
Looked like they were out here, shit, wrangling freaks, I don't know. They had a newt and some kind of noose, like they were putting a tracking device on it or something.
What? Wrangling? What do you mean?
You know, like tying it up, taking samples from it or something, like those guys used to do on that wildlife show. Pretty fucked up. They got chased off by swarmers, bugged the hell out. They left some gear behind, a radio.
Wait, you don't think that Sarah...
No, I don't know.
I'm just... And he's alive, Boozer. He's alive. O'Brien. One of them. Nero. I'm gonna track him down. If I can, I'm gonna get some answers.
Damn it. Okay. Look, I'll be able to ride soon. I'll help you, Deke. If he's alive, we'll find the bastard.
You're goddamn right. I'm gonna check in later. Deacon out. Okay, O'Brien. Where the hell are you?
Hey.
So I'm sort of lost. I was hoping you could help me out.
I'm sorry, you're lost?
Yeah. I'm looking for the old Belknap Road, and there's not a lot of signs around here.
You gotta be kidding me.
Nope.
What? What is it? What? Oh. It's great. That is just perfect. That is great. That is great.
So about those directions?
I'm really sorry. I don't know where Belknock, Belknap, Belknee,
Belknap?
Belknap, that's the one. And I don't know where it is. I really can't help you. I'm sorry.
So no, then?
Nope.
Okay. Well, thanks anyway.
Hey!
Could you use a ride?
Yes, I could. Thank you for finally offering. I'm Sarah.
I'm Deacon.
Oh, well, sorry about the mess. I don't know, how do I, this contraption?
Pretty much what you think, just throw your leg over, yeah.
Okay, there. Whoa. Okay. Ready. Hey! Hey!
Hold on tight.
Thank you so much.
No problem.
It's just, there are no bars out here, so...
Well, sure there is. There's a place called Crazy Willie's up the road. There's,
No, I meant cell phone reception.
I knew what you meant.
Right, of course. Anyway.
So what's a nice girl like you doing in a place like this?
You know, I ask myself that all the time. I do research. You know, I study things.
Thanks. Had no idea what research was.
Sorry, I do plants.
You study plants?
Yeah. Hey, look out!
Shit! Are you okay?
I'm just... Oh, Lordy, that was close.
Hey. You sure you're okay?
Yeah, I'm fine. I just... Oh, my God. Hey. I've got cell phone reception. Hey. Yeah, I'm fine. I just... The car you gave me, it's a real piece of shit. I need a tow. I'm on, I don't know where
Road 42.
Road 42? Yeah, I'm about a mile up. Okay, I'll see you when you get here.
Come on, I'll take you back to your car. We can wait for the tow truck.
I don't know.
Well, all right. I'm sure when those boys come back, they'd be happy to give you a ride, so...
Okay, all right. All right, I just give me a second.
They'll be any minute now.
All right. Screw it. Let's go. Just drive a little careful this time, okay? You weren't really lost, were you?
Well, that all depends on who you ask. My ex would say I've been lost for years.
Well, you certainly know your way around here.
So you're not from around here?
No, I'm from Seattle. The company that I work for, they opened this lab here, so here I came to the middle of nowhere.
To research plants.
That's right, I already told you I forgot. The company that I work for, they do work for this bioengineering firm, and some of the plants that I look at are pretty rare, and they just happen to grow here.
That has got to be the best thing I've ever heard. What the hell?
Clean! We got company!
All right, gentlemen.
Smart now, huh?
Got here. That's big bad biker, huh?
Yeah. Yes. Hit him again.
How you like that, biker boy?
Lovely. Do it. Come on. Hit him.
Not so tough now.
Hit him.
You don't learn, do you, biker boy?
Oh yes. Yes.
Oh, teach him. Teach him good. Yeah. You like that? How about that? Oh, shit.
I'm out.
Hold up! Roll, goddammit! Roll!
Oh, Jesus. Oh, my God. No. Oh, my God.
Hey.
I'm so sorry.
No.
I don't even know. I just was looking in your bag, and
no,
I saw that, and I... Oh, my God, I could have killed somebody.
Well...
Oh, shit.
Yeah, but you gotta kind of aim it at them first.
I've never done anything like that before.
Hey,
It's okay.
I saw it in your bag,
and I tried to call
you
the police,
good.
But there were no bars.
You know what we're gonna do?
No reception.
I'm gonna wait right here until your guy comes.
Okay.
Thank you.
I've never done anything like that.
Huh. Could have fooled me.
Yeah?
Tucker, Hot Springs Camp, you there? I'm gonna need more info on that survivor Larson spotted in Marion Forks.
Deacon, I already told you everything I know. Young, a woman. Wait, he mentioned Hungry Jim's. That old pancake house by the East Bridge.
Lumberjack, big stack of pancakes. Yeah, I know the one. Okay, I'll start there.
You do that. And remember, bring her to me. A group of drifters came through the other day, traded us a few guns. Maybe something you could use.
I'll keep that in mind. Deacon out.
See if I remembered how to make anything. Stop by when you can. I think you'll like it.
Boozer, thank you. Yeah, I'll stop by later. Camp. These are the assholes who've been ambushing the roads around here. Of murderers and thieves, and I can't let any of them escape. There's one. Gotta finish this.
What was that?
You like killing drifters, is that it? How do you like it now?
this take these.
What's that?
How many of you are there? That don't matter. Not enough. It's clear. Now you know how it feels. Being on the other end of it, yeah. Yeah. Bunker, yeah. I bet they had a bunker. Just gotta find it. Gotta kill them all. Every last one of these murdering sons and bitches. One down. Let's do this. Got it.
Need this more than you.
Yes. There we go. Could use this again. You like stabbing him in the back, huh? Never. I like this.
Oh, you can't hide, you son of a bitch.
Getting low on ammo.
Finally.
Last one. Gotta finish this. That all you got? Yeah, that's what I thought. Next time you set up an ambush, don't pick on the wrong guy.
All right, where did you hide your bunker, huh? I know you got one. Down the hatch.
This is Radio Free Oregon. The truth shall set you free. Many of you probably don't remember the Cold War, but living through it was a special kind of hell. Every time you heard a plane flying overhead, you'd think for sure that this is it. That's the one coming to drop the big one on us. And we lived through the Red Scare. know if his neighbor was an American who... bled red, white, and blue. Or a communist red to the bone. Made it hard to trust. My father, God rest him, taught me the only way to be safe in dark times was to go underground. Built my first bunker with him. But we couldn't build it out in the backyard, with a neighbor spying. Had to go out into the woods, a ways from the road, where no one would happen upon it. With a bunker, you knew that if the country went to hell in a handbasket, you could open that manhole cover, climb down the ladder, and you'd be safe. With your radio, and your hoard of food and ammo. Things haven't changed. Better to dig a bunker than an early grave. This is Mark Copeland for Radio Free Oregon. Don't believe the lies.
Yeah, Cope? How'd that work out for the poor bastards who owned the one that I just cleared out? Huh? Not so good, I'm guessing. Since they were all dead long before I ever got there.